the quantum realm seems to lend itself to extremes. Extremely small, cold, fast, and extremely accurate. As technology evolves and our ability to see the universe on a quantum scale increases, what will we do with this new visibility? The scale at which quantum effects are often studied is on the order of nanometers or less. How small is a nanometer? Well, there are 25.4 million nanometers in 1 inch and about 100,000 nanometers in the width of a piece of paper. So really, really extremely small. A system that tiny is also delicate and difficult to study because it's so susceptible to disruption. The famous physicist Richard Feynman is one of the pioneers of quantum physics, and even he is on record as saying,
"Nobody understands quantum mechanics."
That's partially because particles behave very differently and counterintuitively on the quantum scale, and also because it's difficult for scientists to understand effects that they can't observe. Quantum effects are everywhere, even in biological systems. Since Feynman's day, technology has advanced, and researchers have designed clever ways to observe quantum interactions. One research group in Japan aligned an array of quantum sensors called nitrogen vacancy centers. This could be the first step towards measuring the behavior of protons within a protein sample. When measuring effects that are really tiny and subtle, a common trick scientists use is indirect observation. They don't measure exactly what's going on. They measure the effect that behavior has on something else that's easier to record. In the case of a protein sample, the behavior of protons in the protein would have a measurable effect on the nitrogen vacancy centers that form the quantum sensor. The nitrogen vacancy centers basically act as a canary in the coal mine, indicating to the scientists what's happening at the quantum scale that they can't observe in a way that they can observe. NV centers occur as impurities in the crystal structure of diamond. These impurities happen at specific locations throughout the crystal structure, and each provides a single photon signal that can be detected by nuclear magnetic resonance. Quantum interactions with the sample would perturb the NV centers in a predictable way, and researchers would be able to measure these changes. But our measurement abilities are limited, and it takes a lot of these NV centers perfectly aligned to create a readable signal. Until now, such alignment wasn't possible, but thanks to a processing technique engineered by the group in Japan, we may soon be able to make real-time measurements of quantum processes within biological systems. Tools like this could tell us about the quantum mechanical relationships that drive behavior of molecules, and could even help us detect individual protons inside a cell. Until this point, scientists and engineers have relied on classical computer models and supercomputer simulations of quantum mechanical interactions to predict complicated biological effects on a subatomic scale. But we're moving inextricably closer to the day when we might just get close enough to image quantum behavior in a living organism, which would be bananas. As a molecular neuroscientist, I'm excited about what this could mean for cellular biology and drug discovery. Better understanding of the entire process when a drug binds its target protein could make experiments performed during the research and development phase more targeted, speeding up the discovery process and reducing the large failure rate of candidate drugs. On a more basic level, the ability to measure and observe quantum interactions will contribute to our fundamental understanding of the universe. And maybe one day soon, we can prove Feynman wrong. If you love all things quantum, you should check out this video I did a few years back on just how quantum computing could change the world. And while we're on the subject, nitrogen vacancy centers in diamonds could also be important for engineering quantum computers. Thanks for watching Seeker.